Hello. How are you? Please have a seat and make yourself comfortable. I'll be with you in 1 second. I have a really important email I need to send out. All right? While you're waiting, I have this bowl of Icelandic candy that the candy man brought around. I figured I'd buy some. There's some chocolate covered licorice, candy coated licorice, some jellies in here, jelly beans, some solid chocolates as well. So if you'd like, feel free to help yourself. Just give me one second, okay? Thanks for your patience. Well, it's great to finally meet you. Thank you very much for taking the time out of your hectic day to meet with me. I'm assuming that you received the company memo that was sent around last week. So I'd like to go over that, but don't worry. You don't have anything to worry about. I'm not handing out pink slips. But I do want to go over the purpose of that memo and why you're here. And then at the end of our, of the meeting, because of how much you've been doing for the company and how stressed out you must be, I thought we would have a nice little kind of kick back a little bit and relax. I have a few things that I use myself, personally. When I'm starting to get stressed out, like, this Red Swingline Stapler that I brought with me from my previous job at Initech. It's beautiful, isn't it? I was able to get a hold of it from Milton before the whole place caught on fire. And, a few other things like... this Zen garden. Thought it would be something nice that we could end the meeting with. So we'll take a look at that. And a few other things. So, well, why don't we get on as to why you're here? I've heard some really good things about you. Let me just sign back in here. And just pull up your record. So, as for the memo, the company is going under a restructuring phase. I'm not sure how much you know about that, but as part of the process, they're moving a lot of the managers around, including myself. Thus, I'm, you know, the new guy that you'll be reporting to, and everyone else in this department. It's the company's way of trying to inject some new ideas, try to, you know, bring some, you know, fresh ideas, revitalize the departments, and most especially move the managers around to make better fits, so the teams just gel better and work better with each other. And so I thought I would take this moment to get to know all of the employees that I'll be working with. I like to think that, you know, we're on the same level, even though our pay grades may be a little bit different. I like to consider us, you know, a team. So, like I said, it's really nice to meet you. I've heard, based on your record, heard some really good things about you, especially from your previous manager. Your work ethic is exceptional. I mean, you always, you know, do what's, you know, asked of you. You'll take on some additional tasks. You know, hardly ever a complaint, which is great. I mean, you've been putting in a lot of hours, and you know, I want to let you know that we appreciate that, which is another reason that I've asked you here, and we'll get to that in a second. So, yeah, I mean, you've been working overtime when asked to. You really are one of the company's star performers, without a doubt. And you've also had minimal absentee days, which is great. I mean, you know, things happen, you know, I mean, let's be honest. Employees call out sick, managers call out sick. We all have, you know, just those days when we don't want to show up to work. By the way, my deepest and sincerest sympathies for your loss. What you've just gone through a couple of days ago when you called the office. your goldfish. Yeah. I'm very sorry to hear about that. How did your goldfish pass away? It drowned. That's horrible. I'm sorry to hear that. How did the funeral proceedings go? Yeah. I'm sorry I couldn't be there. But I want you to know that I can relate. About a few months ago, well, my pet potato died. I don't know what happened. I was caring for it, just like the owners of the store, told me to feed it nuts and bolts, old shoe, exercise, but I don't know, it just, 2 weeks later, it was just dead, laying there in the cage. So, but, anyway. So hopefully you're feeling a little bit better. The day's off and, yeah. Okay, great. All right. So where were we here? So, you've just been, an amazing, outstanding employee. And, it doesn't seem that you've been compensated very much for it. Is that fair to say? Yeah. It's one of the reasons why I brought you in here. I'm a bit of a maverick. When it comes to management, my management style. And, I don't think a lot of the companies that hire me understand that at this moment. So, let me draw a little graph here. So I guess we would say that this would be the amount of work that you've been putting in for the company. And we'll say this way is your salary. Hopefully you can see that well. Okay. All right. So your work for the company, your efforts, the time you've been putting in, including overtime, has pretty much increased over time. Safe to say, yeah. Okay. However, your salary has been fairly stagnant, especially when taking into consideration the cost of living, the increase in company health benefits. So, that is a one of the reasons why I have asked you in here. Because of your outstanding work ethic, and well, I'm just going to be blunt. We all know these companies, they don't care about us. I mean, they don't, you know, care about you. Management, middle management. It's all about the bottom line. It's all about the shareholders, the stock price, the company budgets, expenses, keeping costs and expenses down, and keeping the executive bonuses up. I know how the game is played. So that's why, between me and you, I want to help you out a little bit. I want to give you, because you've been, how much work you've been putting in for the company, and with the lack of compensation that you've received over the years, and, you know, given all those factors, I'm going to work with HR and keep this off the books. I don't give you any five working days you can have free on the house, okay? But that's strictly between you and me. I'm not offering this to any of the other employees. Alright, this is just between me and you. And I feel it's, you know, you deserve a break. In addition to whatever, you know, vacation days, sick days, PTO days that you already have. Alright? Not only that, but I want to give you a promotion. So, whatever your current pay grade is, we're going to increase that by a, I can't go too high without people getting suspicious, but we'll give you a 8% salary increase. And the next level of your job, a new job title, okay? So how's that sound? All right. No. It's really it's. It's my pleasure. I mean, like I said, we know how these companies are, and if I can even stick my neck out and put my own job at risk, knowing you know, I can do my little part to help out someone like yourself that works really hard and deserves a lot more. You know, I mean, these executives with their ridiculous bonuses and their, you know, six-figure salaries, and they don't work hard. They don't work. They're just in meetings, flying from one place to another. All they know how to do is use big words. That's about it. I mean, you know, they, you know how they got to where they got to. Just by a lot of, you know, kissing up. That's all. So that is the good news or the great news. All right, and I'll be putting that in effective in the coming days. All right, but yeah. All right. So, other than that, yeah, you don't have to worry about me. I can, I'll get a job anywhere else if they ever catch wind of this. I'm not worried about it. I like to think of myself as, the Robin Hood of management. You know, steal from the rich, give to the poor, so to speak. All right. So, let me just make a note. Myself here. All right. So that's really the main purpose of why I asked you in here. I want to, personally, get to know you, introduce myself, make sure we're on the same common ground. All I ask is that you continue, with the same efforts and work ethic that you've been displaying, and you understand what's happening with the restructuring. There may be layoffs down the line, which is another reason why I wanted to do this for you. That's really it. Did you have any questions about, the restructuring process, about me? Anything happening I should know about in the department? Yeah, I worked at Initech. I was a manager there. Mm-hmm. I worked from my way up, from the bottom up. I worked for, there's a guy I couldn't stand, what was his name? Lundgren, something like that. All day long, all I did was collate and staple TPS reports. It was the worst job I ever had, but, I worked my way up into management, and, here I am, so. Anything else? The vending machine? Yeah, what about it? You don't like the selection of snacks? Okay, I can, okay, yeah, sure, I can. Let's make another note of that. Vending machine does not provide sufficient sustenance choices. Okay. Anything else? The restrooms. Yeah. Etiquette. I wish more people would just take an extra moment to, turn around before they walk out of the stall just to make sure that there's a nice clean bowl of water there waiting for the next person, if you know what I mean. So, yeah, it's nothing more unsettling than walking into the restroom and not knowing what's going to be behind, door number one or two. Or three. So yeah, I'm not sure if it's the automatic system, but let me go here to facilities. Who's in charge of facilities? Do you know? Okay. toilets. Okay, I think that should do it. All right. Well, anything else? Nope, that'll do it. All right. Well, like I said, in addition to everything that we just went over, I thought it would be a good time the rest of the meeting. I just kind of kick back and relax, and let me show you some of the tricks of the trade that I use to help myself to relax and unwind, especially when I'm feeling a bit stressed out. Sit back, relax, and kick off your shoes. Figuratively, but I'm literally gonna take mine off. There is nothing quite like the sound of shoes. I should say, the many sounds, the many relaxing sounds that nice pair of shoes generates. Now, when I've had enough of being aggravated by certain employees, or when my higher-ups are breathing down my neck, this is just one of the things that I do that helps me to unwind and reach that Zen state of mind. Have you ever done this before? I highly recommend it. Anytime during the workday, especially if you're stuck in your cube, take your shoes off and don't worry about it if any of the other employees happen to see you doing this. You know, I was watching, finally got around to looking up what was it that your friend said when you called out sick? ASMR. Yeah, I went on to YouTube and looked into that. Oh man, it's the greatest thing that I've ever seen in my life. I'm just sitting here at my desk, and I'm just zoned out. I'm feeling all those, what do they call it? The tingles. Yeah. It's like the greatest thing ever. Ever. So in a way, you know, it was kind of a good thing that your goldfish died. You never would have called, and I never would have found out about ASMR. So I'm thinking about making my own videos. I don't know. I'm sick of working this management job. I wonder how much money you can make making videos on YouTube. That your friend of yours that called in for you, that dude's weird, man. He makes some really, I don't like his videos too much. But there's some other people out there I like. I won't name names, but some good folks out there. Anyway, so what else we have? Oh yeah, the other day I went to my favorite sushi restaurant. And got a bottle of ramune. I believe that's how you pronounce it. Ramune? Ramune? It's got this marble inside of it. Very mesmerizing. reminds me, I picked up something new for my office. Got to take out my lunch. Here it is. This is something else that's I find quite relaxing. This is called Stress Paul. It says, feeling stressed, overwhelmed, tense, under pressure. Don't get stressed. Take it out on Paul. When you're feeling stressed, punish Paul to keep your sanity. So it's a rubber stress ball. I picked this up at one of those big box bookstores. I'm gonna open this up. He doesn't look too happy. Well, you can just squeeze pull right in your hands. Squeeze his head. I guess you can just take out all your frustrations on this. Individual named Paul. It's kind of strange. What did you do to deserve this? All right, well, I'm gonna just put him up there. See if he'll stay. Maybe not, he can just lay there, curled up. There. Okay, let's see what else. Ah, yes. My red swingline stapler, like I said. It's been with me all these years from Initech. As much as I hated that job, I loved this stapler. It's just like you. Top performer. What do you think about that sound? Is that tingly, as they would say it? Looks like I need to put some more staplers in here. Staples. know, maybe I could get away with making an ASMR video right here from within my office. I just need to come up with a pretty cool name for my channel. Maybe Management Tingles, or The ASMR Manager. Let's open this up here. Makes a really cool sound. What'd you think about that? Hmm? All right. Let's see what time it is here. Okay. I got this meeting scheduled for an hour, but it's okay if we go over. Your health and well-being, you know, is very important, not just, you know, for you, but for the company as well. You know, a happy, stress-free employee, you know, that's what it's all about. All right, what else do we have? I have this Rubik's Cube. I'm terrible at it. Now it helps to pass the time and get my mind off things. for me, it's not really about solving the puzzle than it is just enjoying it and trying to solve it, but these are simple things that you can do. Take a moment from your job. Take your shoe off, like I showed you. Tap on your stapler. Get a Rubik's cube for your desk. Get a paw. Yeah, so there's that. Of course, tape dispenser. That's sand in there. Helps keep it weighed down. There's nothing like pulling off some tape. What else do I have for you? nice little bag of rubber bands. How about this hole puncher? And this table remover. Probably a lot more that I could show you, but I don't want to run too far past our scheduled time for this meeting. Why don't we finish up with our little Zen garden, okay? Make some nice little designs right in the sand right here on the desk. And if you find that relaxing enough, you can just feel free to take a little nap in the chair, all right? Okay. Again, it was very nice to meet you. And, you know, good luck with everything. Trying to get too stressed out and overwork, all right? And remember our little arrangement, okay?